Alright, what's going on guys? Fortminor back at it again in here for another video for you guys for today. And in here today for a video response to a good friend of mine that's bostonfan79 and a video that he did not too long ago, which pretty much talks about, you know, top 10 favorite WWE pay-per-views, which I thought it was a good video. So I'm in here continuing the, you know, video response, and hopefully you guys as well will continue the video response, or you can drop your comments down below and tell me what are your top 10 favorite WWE pay-per-views, whether it be currently or from the past or even both, you know, that's fine too as well. So definitely either, you know, drop a video response or, you know, drop your thoughts in the comments. And of course, as always, I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts and opinions. You know, with this, to me, you know, it really isn't in any particular order. So, you know, with that being said, I am going to kick things off here. In the pay-per-view, I know SND, another good friend of mine, you know, mentioned this pay-per-view before. It's one of his favorites, and I could agree it's one of mine too. Even though I don't have that on DVD, hopefully sometime down the road I will. I get it, you know, with some of the 2002s are pretty much rare to find these days. So if I get to find it somewhere, you know, hopefully I will. And if I do, that'd be great. But I am kicking things off with Revenge 2002. You know, this is where we also got to see pretty much the debut of John Cena and where it all started pretty much for him there. Not only that, we had Rock versus Kurt Angle versus The Undertaker. We had a triple threat match going on there. So we had a couple other things going into there with Vengeance. So, you know, Revenge was, you know, a good summer pay-per-view. Now that it's back, you know, coming into the fall, like I mentioned before, which is a good thing. Hopefully Vengeance will now be, you know, pretty much sticking around. I kind of like it during the summer, but, you know, I guess that's fine, you know, with that being, you know, around November pretty much. So, anyway, with that being said, I am happy that's back. So, Vengeance 2002 is yes on this list. Coming in with the next one here, I got Backlash 2004. Definitely one of my favorites as well. On this one, we did get to see a couple of good matches here. I'm just going to name two right now. We got Randy Orton taking on Mick Foley. And of course, you know, it was a great match too as well. You know, definitely could watch that one back and you know, keep rewatching it, you know, so, you know, won't get tired of that match. Next match, you know, that I have on here, we got the Triple Threat rematch from WrestleMania 20. Of course, we got Triple H taking on HBK and Chris Benoit for the World Heavyweight Championship. Even that, and as well as their matchup at WrestleMania 20 were just as good, so I enjoyed, you know, both, you know, matches as well. Next pay-per-view that I have here, and that is Royal Rumble 2003, and this is where Brock Lesnar won his pretty much first time ever and only Royal Rumble 2 as well. So, you know, I was pretty shocked at that time, you know, to see, you know, Brock Lesnar win the entire thing. You know, we had a couple of cool, you know, surprises and stuff like that in there as well. And, you know, a couple of good matches on the cards too. So, you know, can't really complain about that. So, Royal Rumble 2003 is on this list. Next pay-per-view I got here, and that is SummerSlam 2002. As well, one of my favorite SummerSlams. This one, you know, getting into this, we have The Rock taking on Brock Lesnar for the WWE Championship. You know, this, at that time, you know, of the pay-per-view, I was pretty pissed off about, you know, Brock Lesnar winning the WWE Championship. Of course, you know, I wanted to have The Rock retain the title, but of course, you know, that didn't happen, and Brock Lesnar did win the championship, which I got used to Brock Lesnar later on, you know, as, you know, things started to move on with him and stuff like that. And now I'm a, you know, fan of Brock Lesnar, especially now that he's in the UFC. You know, sucks he is at now. You know, he's not really pretty much feeling well, so hopefully he will get well soon, and you know, come back to you know, doing some more fights. So that's it when it comes to that. Next thing I got here, and that is Survivor Series 2002, of course being held in Madison Square Garden, where we had the first ever Epic Elimination Chamber matchup, and that's where HBK won the world title, like bostonfan mentioned. So that as well is also on this list. So I don't really have to go through that, you know, pay-per-view too much. But, you know, what we also did get to see as well, you know, Victoria, you know, I believe she did a debut around that time too, and then eventually won the women's championship, which I'm not mistaken, from Trish Stratus. So You know, with that, you know, that also happened. So there are a couple other stuff as well that happened, but Survivor Series 2002 is on this list. Next pay-per-view, moving along, we got SummerSlam 2006. We got HBK taking on, you know, Hulk Hogan in this, and of course that's also on this, you know, as well. So you know, SummerSlam 2006. You know, I thought that was a good pay-per-view as well, and SummerSlam, of course, is one of my favorite pay-per-views of the year, so that's also on this list. Next one, moving along, we got Royal Rumble 2008. Of course, I went to this pay-per-view. It was good to experience this one live. Of course, this was at the time when Ric Flair was having his career-threatening matches. We had a matchup between Edge and Rey Mysterio, which was good to see live as well. And, of course, you know, the Shocker. At the Royal Rumble match with John Cena returning, which, you know, I was pretty surprised about and really wasn't expecting him to show up there. So, of course, you know, this is on my list as well. Next one I got here, we got Vengeance, going back to Vengeance. We got Vengeance 2005. This is where we see Triple H versus Batista 3 inside the Hell in a Cell and for the World Heavyweight Championship. And, you know, that was a good, you know, Hell in a Cell as well. Of course, we had other matches. And I believe Christian was having a match. I don't know if it was a tag team match, but I know he was at the, you know, event. But anyway, you know, that is on the list. Next pay-per-view, we got WrestleMania 20. Of course, you know, one of my favorite WrestleManias. You know, in this, we did get to see, you know, Eddie Guerrero taking on Kurt Angle for the WWE Championship. And, of course, like I mentioned before, we had Chris Benoit taking on Triple H and HBK. And, as well, we had The Rock and Saw Connection taking on Evolution in a couple of matches. As well as Boston Fan mentioned, you know, we had John Cena taking on The Big Show. And where John Cena won the United States Championship. So, you know, a lot going on, you know, there as well. So, definitely one of my favorite WrestleManias as well. And, last but not least, of course, I talked about this before. And I'm sure most of you know where I'm going to go with this, and that is WrestleMania 18, of course. You know, Rock versus Hogan, we had Jericho versus Triple H for the Undisputed Championship. We had, you know, Stone Cold Steve Austin taking on Scott Hall. You know, we had The Undertaker taking on Ric Flair in this, so we had a lot of matches, you know, pretty stacked card for that pay-per-view. So that pretty much does it and end things there with my top 10 favorite WWE pay-per-views. Of course, you know, there's a lot more favorite pay-per-views, you know, that I enjoy, so, and I'm sure there's going to be more to come as well. So with that being said, you know, guys, definitely let me know what your guys' favorite pay-per-views of all time, you know, top 10, you know, definitely leave your comments in the comment box or leave a video response. It's up to you. Of course, as always, I'd love to hear you guys' thoughts and opinions. And within the hot seat, it probably will be uploaded either sometime by the weekend or probably sometime by, you know, next week. So, you know, in the hot seat will be, you know, back shortly. So definitely you guys aren't really going to miss it. I do have a great show lined up for you guys. So that about does it for this video response. And as always, I will talk to you guys later on. Peace.